Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome to our Heather Tech channel and welcome to the new video. So today we have very important topic. I hope you all are very well and in safe condition. I hope you will be in safe condition as well. So we have very important topic as well today. So the last video we discussed about the ultrasonic range sensor. Okay, I hope you practiced well and you have learned how you can connect the ultrasonic sensor with Group Pi or Raspberry Pi device. Okay, today we will discuss another sensor today. So can you guess what sensor we can discuss? Yes, we can discuss a very important sensor that is called humidity and temperature sensor. Temperature and humidity sensor. This is a sensor. So its price is around $5.9, around $6. You can see this is a $6 in price. So this sensor we will use in our Group Pi, and it will take a live temperature. Continuously it will take a live temperature. Okay, so you can monitor the temperature of your house, your factory, and outside temperature you can monitor. Okay, so let's come and we can connect the devices. This is humidity and temperature and humidity sensor, and I have connected this sensor to D7, digital port number 7. Okay, and then I also connected the buzzer sensor, in digital port number 6, and I have this LCD I also connected. I need to also take the output on this LCD as well. Suppose if this device is not connected with the LCD, my TV or monitor, so I can also I can monitor the temperature in this LCD. Okay, so I have connected here with I2C port. So the basic purpose now let we can design one project. Okay, in this project what I did, it this is a simple program in a Python. This is a simple project which I have designed in a Python. In this project it will continuously monitor the temperature, okay, the live temperature, and plus what it will do if the temperature will increase greater than and equal to 26, what it will do, the buzzer will be on, and it will also print the message the temperature is greater, mean the temperature is increasing. So we give this temperature, okay, and if other than this, the buzzer it will be off. So this is a simple program. What I did, it the buzzer I have connected with digital port number 6, and the sensor, humidity and temperature sensor, temperature and humidity sensor I have connected with port number 7. Okay, so the RGB, this is the color, no need to think about this one. This is just for the color setup on your LCD, okay, which I have connected with I2C port. So this is the color scheme. Okay, set RGB color, red, green, blue color. Okay, this is the color scheme. So these are the libraries, as we already discussed. So these libraries you need to import. Okay, the important thing is this project, what it will do, it will continuously monitor the temperature, it will continuously take the environment temperature. If the temperature will raise up to this specific point, this value, so it will generate the alert message, the buzzer will be on, and what it will do, it will also show the print message on the screen. So let me run the program, you will see the output. See here, now I will run the program, there you will see the output. You can see, let me save, and you can see it will unexpected error, mute karo zara. Okay, now you can see the output. See, this is the temperature. If the temperature will increase, the buzzer will get on. You can see. So we can also show you the devices here. You can see the temperature is also displaying on this LCD screen. You can see. So now I will just hold, I will just give little bit heat to this temperature and humidity sensor. You will see it start generating the alert messages. You can see here. So see, the temperature increase, I just increase little the temperature. You can see the blur, the alert message is generated, and see the buzzer get on, and it also show the temperature on the LCD screen. So this is our project, and you will see. So the output here, everything is working fine. So I hope you like our video. So please subscribe our channel and then like the video. And thank you so much for watching. Thank you.